this episode, I'll show you how to set up a Lightroom catalog from scratch.
Adorama TV presents Exploring Photography with Mark Wallace.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to this week's episode of Exploring Photography right here on Adorama TV. I'm Mark Wallace. Well, I got a question recently from a person on Facebook that said, hey, I am brand new to Lightroom. I've been using it just a little bit for the last couple of months, and I'm starting over. I'm going to set everything up from scratch on a brand new computer. Can you walk me through the settings? Well, absolutely. In fact, I get this question a lot. And I think the key to this entire thing is to think of Lightroom and your photos as a system. Actually, think of it as a library. And anybody that grew up and went to elementary school in the 70s can remember how exciting the library was.
Hi there, young fella. How's the library business?
All swell, Mr. Williams. See you.
Go on. What keeps you and Steve, all the rest of your staff, so keyed up about the library?
Well, what could be more exciting?
Well, what could possibly be more exciting? Well, it's true, once you get to know the library and how it works, it's pretty great. But at first, that might not be the case.
Have you ever watched the way others use the library? There's quite a difference in the way they go about it. Some seem lost in the library. Now the first thing, Gene, is to really get to know this card catalog.
Yeah, the first thing you need to know is how to use the card catalog. Everybody remembers the card catalog, right?
The card catalog helps pupils locate books by author, title, and subject.
So what does all this have to do with setting up Lightroom? Well, Lightroom is a catalog, just like the card catalog, and understanding this and that the whole thing is like a library is the key to getting everything set up and working properly.
With this beginning, and with practice, you can master the organization of your library.
Wait, no, that's not the end, but I think that's the end of those vintage clips. The point is to approach your Lightroom setup like a library system. Instead of books, you have photos. And instead of a card catalog, you have a Lightroom catalog. And just like a card catalog isn't a bunch of books, your Lightroom catalog isn't a bunch of photos. When you import photos into Lightroom, what you're actually doing is you're importing information about those photos and then storing the photos somewhere else. And that has a really big impact on where you store things on your hard drives. Well, you can store all of your files, your Lightroom catalogs, and your photos all on one hard drive, but that's not a good idea for a lot of reasons. One, if you use your computer's internal hard drive for everything, if that crashes and you don't have a backup, well, you're really out of luck. And sometimes if you have a small hard drive like a laptop, well, your folders are going to fill up really quickly and you're not going to have any space left. And so it's a good idea to use an external hard drive, if not more than one hard drive, for backup purposes. So let me walk you through how I've set up my laptop, and you can adjust this according to your needs. So on my laptop's internal hard drive, I've created a folder in my Documents folder called Lightroom Catalogs. Now I use that folder for storing all of my Lightroom catalogs. Now at first you might only have one catalog, but as your photography grows, you might want to have a catalog maybe for family portraits, one for a wedding of client A and client B and client C. You might want to have a sports catalog so you're not mixing all your photos together, or you can throw them all into one big catalog. It's up to you, but I suggest that you create a folder for at least one, if not more, catalogs. Now the second thing I recommend you do is use an external hard drive for your photos themselves. And so on this external hard drive, I've created a photos folder, and inside of that folder, I will create several subfolders for each of my photo shoots. Now we're gonna do all that subfolder creation in Lightroom, but the point is to have an external hard drive with a photos folder that you can throw all of your pictures to. Now remember, your catalog is referencing those external photos, and so you can take those photos and plug them into different computers, and it is very portable. Now, what happens if that external hard drive crashes? Well, you need a backup, and that's what this third hard drive is for. That is to create a backup of your external hard drive, your photos specifically, and that happens automatically when you import photos into Lightroom. There's a little box we can check to make sure that it creates a second copy, so if something happens to that external hard drive, you're going to be just fine. Now this last external hard drive here is to back up my internal hard drive. So I've got a backup for my Lightroom catalog and all my stuff on my computer, and I have a backup for my external photos drive, so no matter what happens, I've got a backup somewhere. So how does this all transpire when we take our little media card, our memory card, out of our camera and plug it into Lightroom? So what happens is the photos go into Lightroom where all the metadata is stored, but the actual photo is stored on the external hard drive that you've designated, and then a secondary copy goes to this backup drive. And then when you make a backup of your internal hard drive using Time Machine or whatever backup software you have, that is backed up on this last hard drive. So Lightroom catalog goes on your internal hard drive, your photos go on an external hard drive, and a backup of your photos, a backup of your computer. All right, well, let's put all this into practice. Now, what I've done here is I've opened three windows to show you three physical hard drives. Now, up in the upper left-hand corner of my computer here, you can see that this is my Macintosh hard drive, my internal hard drive here. And in my Documents folder, I have my Lightroom Catalogs folder. Inside that Lightroom Catalogs folder, I have another folder called Travel Photos. That's where I'm storing my Travel Photos catalog. And if I open that, you can see it right there, Travel Photos-2 LRCAT. That stands for Lightroom Catalog. That's where my catalog is stored. I've got two other files here. One is called Smart Previews. The other one is just called Previews. I'll explain those a little bit later. Now, this catalog is referencing my other external hard drive that's over here on the right-hand side. This is my photo hard drive. That's my LaCie orange hard drive that I showed you earlier. If I open this Photos folder, I'll just double-click that and put this into List View, you'll see that I have a bunch of subfolders here. I have Argentina and Australia and Backpack and Bahamas and Bolivia. And so when you import from your memory card, from your camera, when you go through Lightroom, Lightroom has the ability to create subfolders on your external hard drive and call them different things, and you can organize things by name and date and all kinds of things. So we'll get to that in just a bit. The important thing is to have a folder called Photos, or whatever you want to call it, I call it Photos, on an external hard drive. Now my third folder down here, you can see this third window, this is my backup drive. This is a 2 terabyte, I just call it my 2 terabyte orange drive. Right now it's got some videos, and I'm going to create a folder on this. So I'm going to create a new folder, and I'm going to call it Backup. And that will keep a backup of my photos, and I'll show you how that works when we zip over to Lightroom. So what I'll do first here is I'm just going to open up my Travel Photos catalog, and then what we're going to do is open and create a new catalog from scratch. But I just want to show you something here in Lightroom. Notice that on the left-hand side of my library module, so we're in the library module here, under folders, notice that I have this Photo HD, my photo hard drive, and it's named exactly like it was in my Finder or Windows Explorer, if you have that. And when you dial this open, or you scroll this open here, you can see that we have all those folders exactly like they were on your hard drive. So Australia, Backpack, Bahamas, Bolivia, etc. That's all there. Now I know that photos, they're always going to be in photos, so I can actually right click on that and I can say hide this parent. So photos doesn't show up anymore. It just shows me the folder names inside of that, and it just makes it a little bit cleaner. Okay, let's set everything up. So the first thing I'm going to do here is go up to File, New Catalog. So we're going to start a new catalog from scratch. New catalog, and it's going to say, where do I want to store that? So I'm going to store this in my Lightroom Catalogs folder. So right there, Documents, Lightroom Catalogs. And this is going to create a folder with a new catalog. So you don't have to create a folder first. Lightroom is going to do that for you. And so if you create a folder and then create a catalog, you're going to have a folder and then a folder inside that. So don't do that. So I'm going to save this as Adorama catalog. So we have something really cool. And when I say create, it's going to create the entire framework for me. It's going to close my old catalog, open a new one. It's totally empty. Let's zip over to the hard drive and see what happened. Let's peek behind the curtain here. So when we do that, notice that now we have this Adorama catalog. And when I open that, I have my Adorama catalog, Lightroom catalog. And then I have this previews. Then I have this journal and lock. What that is doing is it's locking your catalog. So if you're on a shared, like on a network or something, and somebody else tries to open your catalog, it won't allow them. That's what those are. They go away when you close your catalog. So the other thing is, where are those smart previews? We'll get to that in a second. The next thing we want to do is import some some pictures. So I've got some really not so good pictures I just shot around really quickly. I'm going to put my memory card into my computer. And once I do that, I'm going to click import. And my pictures show up here. These are some I just shot around very quickly. Now the important thing is to know how to get these into our catalog and how to get them stored on the external hard drive. So on the right-hand side over here, it's going to ask me what I want to do. Actually, on the top, it's going to say, do you want to copy or move or add? By default, you want to copy these from your memory card to a hard drive. So that's by default, it's going to say copy. On the right-hand side here, there's a little checkbox and it says build smart previews. I recommend that you turn that on. I did an entire video on smart previews, so I'm not going to cover that here, but we've included a link to that video in the description of this file. So turn that on. If that makes sense to you, you can watch that video to see if it does. Now the second thing down here, it says make a second copy too. That's where that backup will happen. And so I'm going to check that as well. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to choose the folder and I'm going to go to this 2 terabyte orange drive, backup, and then I'm going to choose that. So now when my file comes from my memory card, it's going to go to both hard drives. One, my photos hard drive, and the other, the backup hard drive. And that way I have a backup immediately and don't have to worry about if my hard drive crashes. It's all built in. Now the next thing I can do here is rename the file. I don't want to do that. I don't want to apply anything during import, but it's saying, where do I want to store these? What's the destination? So what I'm going to do here is, first of all, I'm going to go to my photos hard drive, my photo hard drive, and I'm going to go into photos, and I'm going to put this in a subfolder. I'm going to call it Adorama TV, and you'll notice that now this shows up under photos. There's a little gray thing saying it's going to create a folder for you, and then you can either organize that into one folder. In other words, everything is going to drop right into that subfolder, or you can tell it to make it by date, and it will look at the date of the pictures that you took, and it'll create different subdirectories by date. So it's up to you, doesn't matter however you want to do it. Once you have that set, if it's something that you do a lot, you might want to come down here, and there's this import preset, and you might want to say save current settings as a new preset. And I've done this for most of the countries that I visit, so I don't have to enter in the location data and all that stuff every time. So I have a preset for a bunch of different places. So if you shoot something, a different location or something a lot, and you find yourself typing this in over and over, you can save a preset and save yourself a lot of time. Now, once that's all done, we're going to say import. That's going to bring everything into Lightroom, all the metadata, all the photos are going to be copied to the second hard drive, a copy is going to be made to the third hard drive, everything's going to be updated, and the smart previews are going to be created. That will take just a little bit of time, but if we go over here now to our Finder, let's look and see what's happening on our hard drive. In the Adorama catalog, notice we have previews here, and then we actually have smart previews. Those were built on our first import. So once you do that, you're always going to have the smart previews. And then we have our catalog. In our backup folder here, we have imported on August 20th, 2015. And we can see a backup of all of those files. So each time you import, it's going to create a little backup. And then over here on my photos hard drive, you can see that it's created a new subfolder called Adorama TV. So everything is neat and tidy and it works just fine. So those are the basics for creating a Lightroom catalog from scratch. There's a lot more that we can talk about, but it would take us an hour or two or three or four to go through all the different nuances and settings and things like that. And so what we've done is we've talked about a lot of those things in the past on Adorama TV. So again, I've linked you to those. The important thing is, remember, it's a library system. Lightroom is a catalog for referencing external files. You should create those files on an external hard drive and have a backup. Keep your Lightroom catalog on your internal hard drive. That way you can disconnect your external hard drive and still keep working and updating and then connect later and update those files. and then make sure you keep a backup copy of your Lightroom catalog on your normal hard drive backup. Well, there you have it. That's all you have to do to set up a very basic Lightroom system. Once you do that, it's going to grow with you over the years. You have room to create new Lightroom catalogs. You have room to create lots of different subfolders and organizational structure on your photos hard drive. And you can do all kinds of things that we'll get to in future episodes right here on Exploring Photography. Well, thank you so much for joining me this week. Don't forget to subscribe to Adorama TV so you don't miss a single episode. We've got tons of content from a lot of different people, and you don't want to miss any of that. So click the subscribe button. It's absolutely free. And don't forget to check out the Adorama Learning Center. There are tons of articles and videos and tutorials on things like smart previews and Lightroom and setting up external hard drives and all that kind of stuff. So check that out. Thanks again for joining me, and I will see you again next week.
Great looking prints at low cost? Be sure to visit our easy to use online printing service. Adorama Pix has professionals who treat your images with the utmost care that you can count on. For a quick turnaround on photos, cards, or albums, use adoramapix.com.